Welcome student, hello, how are you? I hope you are fine. I am Mahishwari ma'am, belong from social department. This is TMHNU Nada Saraswati Public School, Vadabudupatti. Now I take social science, class 7, geography, chapter 2, inside our earth. The earth, our homeland, is a dynamic planet. It is constantly undergoing changes inside and outside. Interior of the earth. Just like an onion, the earth is made up of the several concentric layers with one side. The uppermost layer over the earth's surface is called the crust. It is the thinnest of all the layers. It is about 35 km on the continental masses and only 5 km on the oceanic floors. The mainly minerals constituents of the continental mass are silica and aluminium. It is the called CAL, SI silica and AL aluminium. The oceanic crust mainly consists of silica and magnesium. It is therefore called SIMA, SI silica and MA SIMA. Just beneath the crust, it is the mantle which extends up to the depth of 2900 km below the crust. Knife. The innermost layer of the core with a radius of about 3500 km. It is mainly made up of the nickel and iron and is called knife. Ni nickel and Fe ferrous. Iron. The central core has very high temperature and pressure. Rocks and minerals. The earth crust is made up of various types of rocks. Any natural mass of minerals matter that makes up the earth crust is called a rock. Rocks can be of different color, size and texture. Types of rocks. There are three major types of rock: igneous rock, sedimentary rocks and metamorphic rock. Magma. When the molten magma cools, it becomes solid. Rocks thus formed are called igneous rocks. They are also called primary rocks. Igneous rocks also called primary rocks. There are two types of igneous rocks: intrusive rocks and extrusive rocks. Can you imagine lava coming out from volcanoes? Lava. Lava is actually fiery red molten magma coming out from lava. Interior of the earth on its surface. When this molten lava comes on the earth's surface, it's rapidly cooled down and becomes solid. Rocks formed in such a way on the crust are called the extrusive igneous rocks. They have a very fine grained structure, for example, basalt. The Tekkan Plateau is made up of the basalt rocks. Sometimes the molten magma cools down deep inside the earth crust. Solid rocks so formed are called intrusive igneous rocks. Since they cool down slowly, they form large grains. Granite is an example of such a rock. Grinding stones used to prepare paste, powder or spices, and grains are made of granite. Sediments. Rocks roll down, crack, and hit each other and are broken down into small fragments. These smaller particles are called sediments. These sediments are transported and deposited by wind, water, etc. These loose sediments are compressed and hardened to form layers of rocks. These types of rocks are called sedimentary rocks. For example, sandstone is made from grain of sand. These rocks may also contain fossil fuels, plants, animals and other microorganisms that once lived on them. Metamorphic rocks. Igneous and sedimentary rocks can change into metamorphic rocks under great heat and pressure. For example, clay changes into slate and limestone into marble. Uses of rocks. Rocks are very useful to us. The hard rocks are used for making roads, houses and building. Rock cycle. You will be surprised to know that one type of rock changes to another type under certain condition in a cyclic manner. This process of transformation of the rock from one to another is known as rock cycle. You have already learned when the molten magma cools, it solidifies to become igneous rocks. These igneous rocks are broken down into small particles that are transported and deposited to form sedimentary rocks. When the igneous and sedimentary rocks are subjected to heat and pressure, they change into metamorphic rocks. The metamorphic rocks, which are still under great heat and pressure, melt down to form molten magma. This molten magma again can cool down and solidify into igneous rock. Minerals. Rocks are made up of different minerals. Minerals are naturally occurring substances which have certain physical properties and definite chemical compositions. Minerals are very important to humankind. Some are used as fuel. For example, coal, natural gas, and petroleum. We are using cooking and vehicles, you know. Yes, that is fuels. They are also used to industry, iron, alumina, gold, uranium, etc. In medicines, in fertilizers, etc. Okay, thank you children. Take care. Study well.